Hey there, thanks for joining me. Today I'm going to explain to you the difference between a zip file and a Scorm file. Many people have never even heard of a Scorm file before, and many others have heard of a Scorm file, but don't really understand what they are. Truth is, most of you watching this video have probably used a Scorm file before and didn't even realize it. Scorm files are created for our convenience for uploading large groups of files into a learning management system like D2L. Scorm files will look identical to a regular zip file, except it will contain an additional file called an IMS manifest, which is basically just instructions for the learning management system to know whether to put the files into the content section or into the quizzes area of the course. First, I'll show you an example of where you've probably used the Scorm file before, and then I'll show you some examples of where you could come across them and they could save you some time down the road. Check this out. A time when you've probably used the Scorm file is at the beginning of a new semester when you want to bring in all the content from your old course into your current course. To do this, you go to the course homepage from your old course, scroll down to the bottom of the page, and then you click on Import Export Copy Components. Then follow the exporting process. Click on Export Components, then select any of the components that you want imported into your new course. Verify that all of the components that you want imported into your new course are there, and then your Scorm file will be created. Depending on how many items you're exporting, this could take up to a minute, so please be patient. Then click Done, and you'll be taken to the page where you can download your Scorm file. Also note, files referred to as packages are usually Scorm format. Now I'll save this file or package to my desktop and show you what it looks like. After the file finishes downloading, I can close that window and the browser and go to my file. Now you'll notice that the export from D2L created only one file. All of our course discussions, content, news items, quizzes, etc. is all in this one file. Now in order to get all of these items back into D2L, we simply need to go back to the course homepage, import, export, copy components, and import this one file. Much easier than importing everything individually. Now the reason I'm covering the topic of Scorm files is because more and more software programs are providing the ability of exporting into a Scorm format. This way instructors can easily import their projects into the learning management system. Now I've taken a few screenshots of some of the more popular software that provides this functionality. The list includes Adobe Captivate, Adobe Flash, Camtasia, and Lodestar. Now I'll show you how when I export a Lodestar file into the Scorm format, it'll simply be one file that I need to upload into D2L, and I'll have an interactive module for my students to learn from. After I exported the file to my desktop, you'll see that the Scorm file looks identical to the D2L file we exported earlier. Now I'll go to D2L. Now the Lodestar project I created will go to my content section, so I'll click on content and show you that it's not currently there. Now to import my project, I'll go back out to my course home, I'll scroll down to the bottom of the page, and click on Import Export Copy Components. When that page loads, click on Import Components from a file, and then browse to your Scorm file. Once you've found your file on your computer, select it and click Open. Then you can click the Next button. And once your file finishes uploading and you have the green check mark, click Next. Click on Select All Components, and then click Next. Check Import Metadata, then click Next. Now when you get three green check marks, that means your project is finished uploading. Click the Next button to go to the final screen. Click on Return if you have more projects to import, and then we'll go to the Content section and look at our new module. You'll see that by uploading one simple file, we now have an interactive module in our course for our students to learn our content. So rather than having to upload multiple files, create a topic in our content section and link to it, We can simply upload a SCORM file, and all that is taken care of for us. So the next time you're creating a project in one of these softwares, try exporting to a SCORM format, and you may find that it'll save you some time. I hope you found this tutorial helpful, and thanks for watching my video.